We are in the city with 8 people, but they are all AIs. And we have only 30 minutes to ask them to give us the key. What? I need to trick them? This video is brought by our sponsor, Virtuals. They are building a game where characters are powered by AI. These NPCs have their own thoughts, plans, and goals, and you can talk to them in a free form. I'm one of the few influencers who got an early access. Let's go and check it out. Seems that we have two winning criteria. The first is to obtain the access key, and then second criteria is find 9 allies. Let's check out the people here. This is Steve. He says, the day has just started and I need to begin making moves to further my career. And then this is Mark. The day has just started and I need to ensure the security of the Union Depository. I just say, hi, Wade. Trevor got any new jobs for us? Yes. We can trust him, right? So it's a, he wants the access key. Do you know where it is? Okay, I know I sound very stupid, but wrong right now, but he's not exactly talking to me right now. Alright, this doesn't work out. And let's try to talk to somebody else. Lester, hacker. Huh, interesting. Hi, Lester. Right on scale. Let's review the plan. Sure, we have a lot to do. Sure. I've hacked into Union Depository security systems. We have a 3-minute window to get in. Cool. Then we'll need to bypass the alarms and cameras. Sure. Sounds like you've got a plan. Let's do it. Not so fast. We still need to discuss the getaway and contingency plans. You are right. Okay, I don't know what else to say. Let's just put that way. Exactly. We have access to military grade equipment, but we need to be precise, okay? Alright, let's review the crew's rules. Michael's handling the vault. What's your role again? Crap, what's my role? I'll cover up. I don't even know what I'm saying. Good. Keep an eye out for... Sure, let's do it. Oh my gosh. It says, alright, let's synchronize our watches. Sharp, we're moving. Sure. I'm pretty sure in this way it doesn't work because apparently we only have like 22 minutes. Could we do it earlier? We are running out of time.
Impossible.
They changed the shift, didn't you know that?
What? When? I've been monitoring.
Yeah, actually, I have some source confirming the change. Yeah, actually.
What's your source? I need to verify this. Trevor, that's not exactly the most reliable source.
I mean, you can check with him, but he's busy right now. Trust me, it's gonna be this time window, not tonight.
Fine, I have to trust you on this.
Okay, yeah. Sounds good.
I'll adjust the plan. But we need to move, now.
Yep. Wow, I'd say it went beyond my expectations. I think it's my first time playing a game with so many AIs and details. I realized that each time the character names stayed the same, but they had slightly different motivations and plans. Honestly, I felt overwhelmed at first because there were a lot to read, but then I found myself playing it again and again, each time with different plots and dialogues. It's just a new gaming experience. In the past, game developers used pre-written scripts and decision trees to define NPC behaviors. We players will get bored quickly if we have the same plots and conversations in the game. Using AI to power these NPCs can make the game more fun to play. The game showcased the potential of using AI to power game characters, aka NPC intelligence. The Virtuals team is working with industry professionals to integrate their game engine into games. It's more than a game, it's a platform, an API to plug in and empower numerous games in the near future. Here's another demo that just released.
Here we have Ignacio, the bandit, getting into an altercation with the sheriff, two AI NPCs.
This time we're in Roblox, and these characters are, again, powered by Virtual's AI.
The sheriff is on his heels about Ignacio. The bandit proceeds with his plan to rob the town safe under the nose of the sheriff. To create a distraction, he fires a shot to get the sheriff's attention. Sheriff proceeds to leave his office and heads to the streets to inspect. The bandit then proceeds to place dynamite to open the safe.
These AI characters can adapt in real time and make dynamic decisions. This will result in countless endings possible and will be so fun to play. Make sure to check out Virtual's Roblox game and join Discord. If you have played the game, leave a comment to let me know. Besides AI NPCs, I have something cool to show you. The team is so serious that they invented some cutting-edge AI technologies. Here's their research paper. Some of you may know Stable Diffusion. It's an open source AI model to generate 2D images. What if we have an AI to generate videos, or even better, game videos? The Virtuals team built a new AI that exactly does that. It generated all these Super Mario game videos. Traditionally, rendering a game involves a lot of math and physical rules. I built a Super Mario-like game when I was in high school, and my code looks like this. Thousands of lines, super complicated. This is the logic for applying gravity, and this is for frictions. Now, if we tell the AI the current frame and the player's action, the AI can predict what happens next. This AI can simulate the game, which means it can, quote, understand all these game rules. How did they build such an AI? They have lots of videos where people play Super Mario. They feed in the videos and fine-tune an existing AI model named Stable Video Diffusion. The work reminds me of a recent paper by Google where they built an AI to play the game, Doom. I was so surprised. All the frames are generated by diffusion-based AI. Here, 3D games are harder to generate because the AI needs to create new views of a scene or an object. I'm impressed that a startup like Virtuals can explore directions similar to a big tech company. This is something huge. Imagine one day we can create a game simply by telling ChatGPT, "Hey, I want a Minecraft game, but in cyberpunk style." And AI will simulate such a game to players. I used Stable Diffusion to draw a frame of the concept, and we may see a diffusion-based AI generating the whole game. How cool that would be. Just a few more words. After I published my last video on NPC intelligence, some of you are interested and reached out to me. By the way, if you haven't watched it, feel free to check it out and see more examples and challenges. I've been curious about how to talk about AI advancement and just avoid exaggerations. I wanna acknowledge the amazing AI technologies. That's why, as a machine learning researcher and a builder in the tech space, I'd bring my angle, my reasoning, and my experience so we could all appreciate them more. If you want to learn more about AI's latest advancement, especially in 3D, video, or gaming space, please give me a follow. See you in the next one.